Coming up, we look at multi-geo capabilities in Office 365, which allow you to determine where your data resides within a single Office 365 tenant across multiple regions and countries. Now, in the past, if you had data residency needs, you might have solved it by spinning up various data silos in the cloud or in on-premises. Current hybrid solutions in Office 365 enable a base set of collaboration experiences like document sharing, presence, and email. But you are not able to take advantage of more intelligent capabilities such as search, content discovery that use Office Graph signals to aggregate your content wherever it may live. Multi-geo capabilities in OneDrive, SharePoint, and Exchange services in Office 365 solve this by allowing you to determine where individual users and their data reside. And importantly, they give your users the ability to collaborate using modern experiences such as real-time co-authoring with others wherever they are in a compliant and secure way. Let me start by showing you how you can enable multiple data locations for your Office 365 tenant for OneDrive and SharePoint in two steps. The first thing you want to do is to set up your satellite location for your tenant. Let's say your tenant is currently located in North America, which is abbreviated to NAM, and you want to extend that to Europe and Australia in order to meet your data residency needs. Using the Azure Active Directory PowerShell module, you can run the simple commandlet get MSOL company allowed data location, as you can see in the screen here, and it will show me that currently the tenant is located in NAM, which is North America. Now, I want to add additional geolocation, Europe, to my tenant. I can run a simple commandlet, set MSOL company allowed data location with the parameters service type of SharePoint, because that's the service I want to add. The location is EUR, which is Europe that I would like to add. And then also the initial domain of Contoso Energy EUR, which will be the URL namespace for my new geo. So now when I run the get MSOL company allowed data location commandlet, it shows me that the tenant has two locations, both North America and Europe. Now let's say I want to add the third location, Australia. Again, I run the same simple commandlet, set MSOL company allowed data location. But this time, as you see, the location I'm specifying is AUS for Australia. And the namespace, the URL namespace for that geo is my company name and abbreviated with the location name, that is Contoso Energy AUS. And now when I run the get MSOL company allowed data location, I see that there are three locations now attached to my tenant: North America, Europe, and Australia. As you can see in the OneDrive admin center now, the tenant is extended to Australia, Europe, in addition to its North America location. When I initially set the service type as SharePoint, it automatically also extends the service OneDrive for this tenant. That's the reason why I'm able to now see multiple geolocations even for my OneDrive admin center as well. The next step is to assign users to your new location. Whether these are new or existing users, you will want to set the following attribute, preferred data location, with the set MSOL user commandlet. Here, as you can see, I'm adding Melissa with the parameter user principal name to the preferred data location of Europe. And once I have set this commandlet, I can do a get just to prove it to you that it has been set into European location. Doing a get MSOL user on the user Melissa will return to me that her preferred data location is set to EUR. This confirms to me that now Melissa is assigned to the European location. Of course, if you are synchronizing your on-premises directory, you can use the Azure Active Directory Connect tool to set this value, and you can learn more about this at the link below. For new users like Melissa, once you set this preferred data location property to Europe, her Exchange mailbox and OneDrive will be set up in European location. This concludes the two steps to set up multi-geo. For users with existing OneDrives, there is one additional step. You can use the SharePoint PowerShell module with the new commandlet start SPO user and content move, as you can see in the screen here, to trigger a move of existing users' OneDrive to their new location. In this commandlet, you provide user principal name parameter, which determines which user you want to move to the new geolocation. With the destination data location parameter, you determine which geo you want them to move to. Here, you will select, in this case, I selected EUR because that's one of the newly created satellite geo for my tenant. So now that the multi-geo is set up, let me show you the modern productivity experiences that are available to users in this multi-geo enabled tenancy. Now, users in satellite locations can get the same rich experiences as users in your central location. For example, here I'm logged in as Melissa, who is a satellite user. I'm logged into the SharePoint home experience, and I'm going to do a quick search, let's say for the term energy, because this is a Contoso Energy tenant. And when I do the search, it's going to show me the aggregated results from across the geos. The first results that I see here is from a team site hosted in European location. You can see that by referring to the URL on this result. If I scroll down, there are results also from other team sites in North America. For example, here is a search results that shows a news article coming from the team site in North America. And also, from my own OneDrive hosted in Europe, I have a search results as well. This shows you I get a single aggregated view of results across my enterprise, even though my home geo is Europe. Now, Delve goes even further by surfacing the content trending around me in my organization, regardless of which geolocation the content is hosted in and which geo user shared the content with me. For example, as an European user, Melissa, I can see relevant document signals. If I scroll down here, the Bright Dreams North America site, as well as Wind Energy team site, which is in European geolocation, and also from my own OneDrive, this is hosted in European location. So as you can see, the signals are not only coming from European location, but also from other satellite locations that my tenant has been extended to. These modern productivity experiences are made possible without compromising your data residency needs. Even if Melissa in Europe browses to another OneDrive host location in North America, the service is intelligent enough to redirect her to the European location, which is her home geo, and that's where her OneDrive is hosted. You can see it by referring to the URL that she now got redirected back to where her OneDrive has been hosted. I just showed you the browser experience, but the experience is also seamless to the user in the Office client, Outlook client, OneDrive Sync client, and the mobile clients. The experience is the same no matter the location of the user, and users don't need to remember the site or OneDrive URLs or mail server names to access their resources. Lastly, let me show you what the management experience is like for a multi-geo tenant. Each geo will have its own URL and SharePoint and OneDrive admin centers to manage the sites and OneDrives in that geo. Specific sharing policies and sites can be configured by admins in each geo location. Mailbox recipients rules and other rules can be configured from the Exchange admin center. You can also configure geolocation tailored data loss prevention policies and view the unified auditing showing the activities done by users across the geos in the security and compliance center. Equally, you can configure password policies and licenses in the Office 365 admin portal. Here, I'm selecting the user Melissa, who is an European homed user, and I can change her product licenses at the global enterprise level. So, that was a quick overview of multi-geo capabilities in Office 365. Exchange and OneDrive Multi-Geo is available for preview now. Check out the link below and contact your Microsoft account team for more details. Thank you for watching.